slot for today. We are going to conclude our program with an artist who many of you might also know if you have joined us for the previous Memex. It's Dennis Rudolph, who is a multimedia artist who brings together tradition and innovation. And he materializes the digital by combining the classic genre of painting and new media such as virtual and artificial intelligence. And today, all of us here can be part of an interactive art experience with Dennis. First, he will introduce the latest version of his portal to California City. He will open the portal with artificial... did I say artificial intelligence all the time? That was the mistake. Nobody even said. Augmented reality it is, of course. It doesn't even make sense. He will open the portal with the help of augmented reality, and he will walk over to the other side live, and afterwards, all of us will get to experience the portal ourselves. So please welcome Dennis Rudolph.
I had a little keynote prepared to explain how I ended up using augmented reality apps for my art, since the topic of the evening is of the whole day is seeing the experience. And so I started painting in the virtual reality 4 years ago, and one of the problems I faced was making it visible to see the experience, since it's a digital file I create. And so I ended up finding the solution during a project in the desert, which, as I understood right, this is an illustration for the Divine Comedy by Dali. So this is great, because I wanted to update Rodin's Gates to Hell. And Rodin took all his inspiration from Dante's Divine Comedy. So it's really nice that this is now here. So one of the major updates of this project, which I call Das Portal, was that it should be in between realities. So it should be like in between heaven and hell, if you want. Yeah? And so for 5 years, I struggled to find the right medium, how to actually, because what is, you know, what medium is there and not there at the same time? And then so these virtual reality headsets came on the market, and you could buy them at the Media Markt or Best Buy or whatever. And I started painting the portal in the virtual reality and being on the other side, symbolically, yeah, of this portal. And then I built an app, an augmented reality app that was GPS-based to put it in the desert, in the Mojave Desert in California, which was what, in my mind, is the end of the world, you know? So, and if you have the app, then you can... you can see it, but only if you are in California City. And so if you're an artist and building apps, of course, you always have to update the apps all the time. And then also, so the artwork develops. And for my recent project in Hamburg, in the Hafen City, it's a big exhibition at the moment. It's been prolonged till end of October. I updated Das Portal to a gateway to California City. So you can, since nobody can travel anymore now, it's a pandemic. So the pandemic gave a kind of boost also to my project. And I've been invited to several things that can only happen outdoors now. So it's perfect to build apps for that. And so so this is actually in Hamburg at the moment, but I can try to recreate the project for you here. And we have the portal. And hopefully this works now. And you can, everybody can download the app. I put much work into it. It gives a little story about California City, the end of the world, and me in the city council, and so on. It's for iPhone and Android. And so let's gonna try to bring this to us, you know.
Thank you.
Das Portal.
Yes, or you can find it under Das Portal. Are there any questions for the artist?
That's pretty clear.
Christoph has a question. And I'll pass you the mic so we can record it.
Great presentation, thank you so much. Being passionate of art, but also passionate of technology, I wonder if you also engage with the non-fungible token ecosystem to put your amazing art in the metaverse, in the digital age, and make it also accessible to people who are on that part of the portal, that are already in the metaverse. Have you thought about that?
Yeah, I'm currently working on a project with the platform is not launched yet, but I had the idea to have, with an app, you can see a GPS-based, it's from a series I call Artificial Gods, and you see these huge artificial gods that are painted in the virtual reality and at certain points in the city, wherever. And next to them, there would be a screen that shows the wallet, which actually possesses now this this artwork, you know? So I thought that would be something that would interest me, as you buy it as an NFT, but it's visible for everybody who owns it, which also would draw on the concept of cryptocurrency, that it's everything is visible, and you see how much money this guy has or that, and also it would give me a way to the real world, because there's a real person behind this, and then so that would be a thing that would inspire me so I'm working on it, and let's see if these people don't go bankrupt before they launch the website. Also, we did one exhibition actually in Berlin, where in the gallery rented space in I think it's called Pixel Voxel or something. It's like Second Life. It's you walk through people own buildings, really expensive to buy property, a few thousand dollars, and they staged an NFT exhibition in there. It was 4 months they rented the space, and then I had an NFT in there too.
No. Thank you so much. Julia had a question.
Actually, it's not about the digital part, but do you still actually paint in real life? Because I really like your paintings.
Oh yeah, thank you. No, yeah, of course. Yeah, I try to, please everybody. Yeah, so I'm still painting, and the main inspiration for my paintings are now the things I paint in the virtual reality, so it completely changed my way of working. And what I do is I paint details of these artificial gods, which are huge. So it looks like an abstract painting, but if you have the app, the app only works if you have the painting, then the whole figure comes out of the painting. If I paint like this part, maybe, then the figure comes huge into the room. And so that was kind of a business idea to, you have to buy the painting in order to see the digital thing. It's kind of an NFT.
There's another one.
Yeah, more a comment also. Thanks so much for being again the real art spark and star of the Memex. And we know each other now for a long time. And thanks for sharing your incredible, deep, and in a way also beautiful art. I remember maybe now it's also 6-7 years ago, we had the lovely workshop here, and I think Matthias, and he got also into your artworks, was kind of in his German way raising the question, and at that time you were saying you kind of have failed somehow or something like that. Mm-hmm. And so he raised it, and you also said you are happy with that, mm-hmm. that you have failed. And then Matthias raised the question, what will happen then to you if you're no more failing? So now you're such a successful artist, I mean, you've ever been, but obviously successful, but how do you handle that now? Yeah. Okay.
I mean, you know, it's. I guess I was pretty successful before in failing, since I've also been invited to here, you know, like 7 years ago. Yeah. But yeah, I think the question was, so do you fail if you succeed, you know? Because I said in art, it's failing is success, you know? You make it into the institutions if you fail. But yeah, I think the art world changed. Yeah. They're not so into failing anymore. They want success now, like NFTs, and it's so. I think I'm on a good track now. Feels good.